Google wowed everyone at its annual keynote address at Google I.O. 2023 when it finally ended the waitlist for its AI chatbot, Bard, and we cannot wait to test it. Hey everyone, my name is Ishan, this is Gadgets 360, and today I'll show you how you can access Google Bard. I'll also test it to see if it is any better than the popular ChatGPT. So, let's get started. To access Bard, go to bard.google.com. Log in with your Google account, click on Try Bard, and you're good to go. You can now start asking it questions about whatever you like. One of the major differences between ChatGPT and Bard is that Google's AI is connected to the internet all the time, and there is no limit when it comes to the information it has access to. Unlike ChatGPT, which does not have any information about news and events that have occurred since 2021. Unlike ChatGPT, Bard does not have a paid subscription model, at least not yet. Users also don't have to wait to use it. There are times when you have to write something immediately and you cannot afford to wait till the unavailable sign drops on ChatGPT, and not many people would want to pay to use the features that Bard currently offers. Though this feature has not yet been launched, yet it is one of the most exciting ones. OpenAI does offer some plugins and interoperability with other tools, but that's nothing compared to the potential of Bard when it's integrated with a host of Google productivity apps that people already use. As Google demonstrated, Bard could be very helpful when used to create presentations, spreadsheets, etc. with simple descriptive prompts. Later this year, Google will launch Bard's integrations with apps like Gmail to write entire letters, slides to create unique visuals for your presentations, and sheets to organize data logically, all just using prompts on Bard. In my opinion, Google's Bard will help people be productive right now. But not everyone will be able to use it if Google plans on charging a subscription fee in the future. Let's hope that doesn't happen. That's it for this video. Do let us know if you liked it in the comments, and keep following Gadgets 360 for all things tech.